You're watching KBTX TV, Channel 3, Bryan College Station. Serving Bryan, College Station, and the...
Cure those blues.
The hospital?
Yes.
We're going to the hospital?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, Jordy, come on. Look, it's such a gorgeous day, and I thought you were going to take me to some outdoor cafe.
No. I told you already I need to talk to Wally.
Talk to him?
Right.
You look like you're ready to kill him.
All right, Thomas, enough. I am tired of everybody telling me what to do. I am taking the casino job, that's it.
I'm just trying to find out when you're going to start, that's all.
Next week, okay? Look, at Wally, I'm on your side in this thing, remember?
Well, then why are you giving me such a hard time?
Because I want you to consider what's going to happen as a result of this decision. Mom and Granddad are going to be nuts over this.
I know. But they're going to come around, just like Brenda did.
What about Jordy? Have you talked to him about this? Would you stop worrying about me? You got enough to worry about with Mr. Morgan's surgery. And when that is a success, you're not even going to think about my job, Thomas. Everybody in this entire country is going to know who Dr. Thomas McCandless is.
Talking about $10,000.
You're nuts.
Yeah, I am. That's what I get to face Jarrett Morgan, and I'm here to collect.
Roach problems are where sprays can't reach. That's where roaches live and breed.
Boy, I ain't seen a spray yet that'll kill around
toothpaste.
It's easier to pump.
Triple Protection Aquafresh, a complete toothpaste.
Myrna, come on in.
Hello, boss.
Oh. Oh, don't you look sensational.
Did you buy that in Paris?
As a matter of fact, I did.
Oh, it is smashing. Oh, I made a reservation at Mario's, a little on the late side, so we can have a little aperitif here before we go.
Thank you.
Where's Ronnie? Oh, she's out on a lunch break. Poor dear's been working so hard, I told her to take a nice long one. Ah, to old friends. All right, Paula. What's going on?
What?
Well, I know you well enough, darling, to know you wouldn't invite me to lunch unless something were going off.
Nonsense. I haven't seen you for ages. I thought we'd have lunch together and catch up.
Catch up. Well, don't you want to know the status of my countersuit against Mark and Clarissa?
Oh, yes. How's it going?
Better than I ever dared hope. Mark came storming in here the other night, brandishing the letter that my attorney sent him, and he was absolutely apoplectic. Oh, I wish you could have been here.
Well, what did he say?
What didn't he say? He huffed and puffed about Clarissa's spotless reputation. Well, spotless up until now, that is. And, oh, Lord, the injured dignity of a man in his position being sued for adultery. Some was left in his face.
Well, it sounds very gratifying.
Oh, it was. It wasn't. Even though he doesn't have a leg to stand on, he tried absolutely everything to get me to back down. He was throwing accusations all over the place. As a matter of fact, his most outrageous comment was about you, of all people.
Me? And what did he say?
Well, you won't believe this, Myrna. But he actually said that you won't follow through on this, that you won't go to court and testify against poor Clarissa. Well, isn't that absolutely preposterous, Myrna? Well, of course, I told him he was insane. I said, you are my oldest and dearest friend. You'd do anything for me.
Why should I, Paula? Why on earth should I testify against him? After all my warnings, you still go ahead and carry on with Josh Harrington.
After all the things I did to keep those two together...
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about this casino job my father's given Wally. I knew he wouldn't tell me about it because he figured I'd blow my stack.
Well, I don't understand why you're so upset about it.
Look, Ronnie, my father is setting Wally up.
For what?
To fall on his face. I mean, their only mission in life is to keep Wally and Bender from getting married. They tried the direct tactic, now they're playing it cute.
I still don't understand how your father is setting Wally up. I mean, a gambling casino sounds like the perfect place for him. Lord knows he has the experience.
Well, my father working against him, he doesn't stand a chance. That's exactly what I'm going to tell him.
I don't know.
No, you don't know. Sam Clegg is not your father.
No, I didn't mean that. It just seems to me that if Wally wants to act like an idiot and fall on his face, well, maybe you should let him.
Don't you think you're jumping a gun a little bit here, Smitty? I mean, New York hasn't even called yet.
What is the problem? We know that Morgan has had plastic surgery, and I'll make book that he's Victor Markham. So why don't we just wipe the guy out and do everybody a favor before he makes trouble?
Excuse me, but you don't give orders around here. Neither do I. And you just wait. Understand?
I'm not going back to that place till I get some dough.
$1,000 as an advance.
Hey, wait a minute, Sandy. I got expenses.
Don't push it, Smitty. You just stick close to Morgan and keep checking in with me.
Oh.
And remember, when and if it happens, it's got to look like an accident.
No problem, Sandy. No problem.
Wally, your confidence in me is gratifying, but it isn't necessarily just.
Oh, sure it is.
Wally, this operation is highly experimental. It hasn't even been done in this country. So what? You're going to be hooked up by satellite to the doctors who've already done it in Europe.
Even so, if I was a self-respecting bookie in Atlantic City, I wouldn't take the odds.
Thomas, you're going to pull this off.
Oh.
Hi, Granddad.
Well, I guess you haven't been able to talk any sense into your brother.
Please, no, here, okay?
Look, I'm all through talking. You're a grown man. You have to make your own decision.
That's what I have tried to tell you and Mom.
All I can do is point out how wrong it is. And I'd like to talk to Thomas, if you don't mind, privately.
Absolutely.
Now, we've been missing each other at the house, and I really need to talk to you.
Well, sure, Granddad. Come on in.
I know you're busy, so I won't be long.
What is it?
Well, it's Tyler. I haven't heard from him in too long. He had been calling me every day just to keep me informed, but suddenly the call stopped.
You have no idea where he is?
No. And I'm trying not to let your mother and Julie see how worried I am, and not just about Tyler.
What else?
I'm worried about Judd Diamond.
When you're hot and thirsty,